Quantum computing is the future computing. It is more powerful than a supercomputer, and its technology, its very core concept is different from a classical computer, which we are using every day in our different jobs. The concept of computing and shape of a computer is going to change greatly in very near future to come. So that is our topics today. What is quantum computing, and what is the future of quantum computing? And we will also discuss about the difference and the comparative study between quantum computing and classical computing. This core concept of quantum computing is today's subject of this video. Please watch this video till the end. Before understand quantum computing, we have to understand the core concept of classical computing. In a classical computing, we know that the digital circuit is working on 0 and 1. And at any point of time, for a time-specific period, or at any point of time, it can be that the circuit can, the current can flow through a circuit, or the circuit may be off. That means it can be 0, it can be off or on, or it can be 0 and 1. So it in a normal state, in a particular time, or a particular state, it cannot be 0 and 1 simultaneously. But that is the difference, or core difference, between the concept of quantum computing and the classical computing. And this, before coming to the exact concept of what is quantum computing, we have to have a little bit of knowledge of a very modern and sophisticated branch of physics, and that is called the quantum mechanism. Now, quantum mechanism is a branch of physics. It deals with the subatomic particles, which are smaller than atom, and it also deals with the smaller scale of energy levels of atoms. The quantum mechanics deals with the study of subatomic particles' behavior, how they behave, how their energy level behaves in such a way. So that the quantum computing works on the procedure or phenomena we found in quantum mechanics. It's a hugely developed and sophisticated branch of physics, but the basic core concept is that it deals with the subatomic particles and the energy and the smallest scale of energy levels of those subatomic particles. So coming back to our discussions of what is quantum computing. Quantum computing runs on the quantum mechanical rules. So, or two rules you can say, of subatomic particle, which has been used in devolving the mechanism of a quantum computing. And that is, one is superpositions and another is entanglement. So I'll come to the concept of what is superposition and entanglement. The superposition, both the superposition and entanglement rules, we can see in quantum physics, and the same concept has been implemented in developing or designing quantum computing. So in quantum computing, now what is superpositions? Superpositions, in superposition, any two quantum state can be added to get another valid quantum state. Particles can be in two states at a given time. So that's the one of the core concept of quantum computing, that it can be it can at any point of time, it can be either 0 or 1 or both, which is not possible in case of classical computing concept. So that is where the superposition concept has been applied in devolving the quantum computing. So another concept is entanglement. This quantum mechanical phenomena occurs when pairs or groups of particles interacts in such a way that each particle lose their own independent quantum state, and they become a new identity carrying a different independent quantum state. So that is the two core concept of superpositions and entanglement, which is also the basic conception of designing and developing the quantum computing. If we make a comparative study between quantum computing and classical computing, we see that the quantum computers are able to solve hard computational problem and challenges much faster and efficiently when compared with classical computer. So quantum computers are able to solve hard computational problem and challenges much faster and efficiently when compared to or compared with the classical computer. Quantum computer are capable of solving complex problem. Quantum computer can do parallel processing at a time many processing can parallelly execute it. For example, a 4-qubit quantum computing processor can run 16 calculations simultaneously. So you can see the power of a quantum computer, and that is the future computing. Classical computers are made up of silicon chips, and they work on the core concept of off or on state, or one or zero state. That is always on a particular single state. Unit is marked as, you know, this zero and one unit is marked as bit being zero and one. But contrary to this concept, in quantum computing, the quantum computer in its uses quantum bits or qubits. The concept of quantum bits or qubits, and that is nothing but a superposition of 0 and 1. So a qubit can be 0, it can or 1, or be can be both 0 and 1. So that's the peculiarity or the peculiar conception of the quantum computing. If we see the prospect of and the development of the artificial intelligence, we'll get a new hope from the designing and developing the quantum computing, because if more and more quantum computing is used in AI artificial intelligence field, then artificial intelligence will become more powerful and speedier. So today's classical computer is not that capable of handling huge model or having huge amount of data at a time, and AI will become more efficient and more accurate. Its predictive model will become more accurate with the use of quantum computing, and that's the future we all have. One very disadvantage, you can call, or peculiarity of designing a quantum computing processor is that quantum computers have to be kept, it has to work in almost zero. The quantum computers can work on equals to zero Kelvin, which we know equals to minus 273.15 degrees Celsius, or minus 459.67 Fahrenheit. So there are companies who are telling that they have developed some quantum computing at very near to the absolute zero temperature. So in the days to come, our computer will be in a if been processed, or our quantum computer if been available, and that will be has to be kept, its processor has to be kept at least in absolutely zero temperature. And that is the peculiarity, and that is the challenge for our today's scientific world, that how can this supercomputer, how can this quantum computer can be used in mobile or other kind of devices. So that's the challenges we have to face, and the future has the answer whether we can solve this problem. There are another field which has been developing is the quantum cryptography. See, a classical computer is not always capable to solve complex cryptographic problem. So to solve this complex cryptographic problem, the use of quantum computing is the solution. And quantum computer using the quantum mechanism can solve complex cryptographic tasks which is even not possible by classical computers, and that is obviously going to provide a more secure cyber ecosystem in the days to come. Today's scientific world have lot of hopes from this quantum computing development project, because it can deal and process with huge amount of data which classical computer cannot. Today's modern world are hoping for to build a model of say, for example, a complex human brain, or even the entire world, or even can crack the mystery of universe if we can have quantum computing. Because 2 to the power n, if the n is 1000 and above, then its computational power is a miracle. It's a miracle. It is beyond our imaginations, the power. So that is the thing. If we see from larger perspective, the computer, quantum computer, is in a very infant stage. There are companies like IBM, Google, Microsoft. These are working on it for long. IBM is working quantum computer for over 35 years, and they have come with a quantum computing model. They are working on quantum computing development. Google has also developed their quantum computing processor. Microsoft has come with a Microsoft quantum network systems. DWARE system has announced that they have built the world's first commercially available quantum computer. There are companies like Intel, IonQ, Alibaba. They are also working in building up of a sound, flawless, error-free quantum computing computers in the future. So we are hoping for, and there are a lot of researches going on throughout the world, and the expected result is that to build up a quantum computer which will be error-free, working on large number of qubits, and which will work for a longer computational periods, and obviously we will achieve quantum, and if this been achieved, then we can achieve the absolute quantum supremacy, and that will be the quantum supremacy in its true sense. And the answer lies obviously with the future, whether at any point of time in the future, people are saying that after 5 or 10 years, this quantum computing, quantum computer will be a reality. And I mean to say, the quantum computing, which is error-free, working on a large number of qubits, and which will work for a longer computational period. So the answer lies with the future. With this note, friend, I end up this video. Please comment how you like this video. Subscribe to my channel on electronic evidence and cyber crimes. Thank you once again.